Hello everyone. So in this video we are going to talk about a binary search problem, and the problem was asked in the placement 2019-20, and the name of the company is media.net. So the problem says we are having a matrix of n cross m matrix, and it is containing all positive numbers, and we have to find the maximum size of a submatrix and such that all submatrix of that size, suppose the size of that submatrix is x, so that all submatrix of size x cross x should have sum less than or equals to the given sum. So basically we are going to have a matrix of n cross m, and we are going to have a value k, and we have to find the maximum size of submatrix such that all submatrix of that size x cross x should be less than or equals to given maximum. Fine. And the constraint is that n and m are less than or equals to 1000, okay, 1500, okay. So suppose we are given a matrix 4 cross 4, and the matrix contains element like 1 2 3 1 5 6 7 8 1 8 2 3 3 2 4 1, and the k is equals to 20. So what we have to find is the maximum submatrix of square submatrix such that all submatrix of that size in this matrix should have sum of element less than or equals to 20. In this we are going to have output as 2. Why we are? Because if you can find all submatrix of 2, like 1 2 5 6 is one of them, 2 3 6 7 is one of them, 3 1 7 8 is one of them, 1 8 3 2 is one of them, 8 2 2 4 is one of them, like 6 7 8 2 is one of them. We have to find all submatrix of size 2 cross 2 and check whether the sum of element in those submatrix should be less than or equals to 20. You can find that no submatrix of size 2 cross 2 will have sum greater than 20. Like I think this is having the maximum 3 plus 1 4, 4 plus 7. This submatrix I'm talking about 3 1 and 7 8. It is 2 plus 2, right? So 3 plus 1 4, 4 plus is 12, 12 plus 7 is 19. So this is also less than 19. But if you're going to take 3, suppose if you are saying that my answer is 3, it means all submatrix of size 3, that is 1 2 3 5 6 7 1 8 2 is one, is the first 3 cross 3 submatrix. 2 3 1 6 7 8 8 2 3 is the second 3 cross 3 matrix, and 5 6 7 1 8 2 and 3 2 4 is another, 6 7 8 8 2 3 2 4 1 is another. So you can check that if there is a submatrix of 3 cross 3 which is having sum greater than 20, then 3 cannot be the answer basically. So first of all let us talk about the brute force technique. So what is the brute force technique? So the brute force technique is you are going to check from 1. So I'm going to write the pseudocode here. You are going to check for one. You are going to check for every number starting from 1 to start to minimum of n comma m. Okay, and then you are going to check if I is the answer or not. If I is the answer or not. If I is the answer, okay. Suppose in this case we are getting two options. If I is answer, then you are going to continue further. You are going to check it further, and we have to find the maximum size, okay, not the minimum or anything else. If I is not the answer, it means I have to return the previous value I minus 1, correct? So this is basically the pseudocode. We are going to check for every I whether I cross I can be the answer or not. Okay, we are going to check I cross I. What is I? I is the size of a subarray matrix. Okay, so we are going to check whether I cross I, all I cross I in n cross m is satisfying the property or not. If any of the submatrix is not satisfying that property, it means I cannot be the answer. So basically, we are going to check I if I is the answer or not. So, okay. So this is the check function, I'm going to discuss it. So basically we are going to optimize this. Instead of checking for every value, we are going to apply binary search here. Okay, what we can do is, suppose I am saying x is the answer. X is the answer means all x is the, what does it mean? So it means x, all x cross x submatrix of n cross m is satisfies that sum of elements of x cross x of all x cross x is less than equal to k. This it this is what it means. And since the matrix contain all positive numbers, so it implies अगर x answer है तो इसका मतलब x minus 1 भी answer होगा. Okay, correct? अगर x answer है so it means x minus 1 will also be the answer. x minus 1 वाली समय क्योंकि छोटी वाली तो satisfy करेगी जब बड़ी वाली कर रही है. तो हम इसमें binary search लगा सकते हैं, right? Because if x is satisfying, it means x minus 1 is also satisfying, x minus 2 is also satisfying, x minus 3 is also satisfying. So we are going to check for the mid value. If mid is the answer, then I am going to check into the right part. If mid is not the answer, I am going to check it in the left part. Okay. So this is something I have for you. I am going to explain you a little further. So basically, we shall start. We are going to input n cross m. This is n comma n matrix, and this is maximum sum is the value k which I was discussing with you. And what I am having is I am having a matrix from 1 to n. Index is 1. Okay. So I am going to take I equals to 1, I less than equals to n, I plus 1. This is the input matrix. Okay. So what I am going to explain you what is DP. Okay. So this is for the check function. Okay. Basically. So just forget this. I am going to explain it little further. Okay. This part just leave it. Now we are, I'm going to apply the binary search in this. What is C? I'm going to take low equals to 1 and high is equals to minimum of n comma n. So those who don't know about binary search, I'm going to give the link in the description, so you can just have a look on in that, which explains about the binary search. Okay. So I'm going to apply low equals to min and high is equals to n comma m, because my answer lies between these numbers, right? So then this is why I'm going to put low equals to 1 and high is equals to n comma m. Okay, fine. So this is a binary search syntax I'm having. While high minus low is greater than 1, int mid. Mid is equals to high plus low divided by 2. This is the check function. If mid cross mid is satisfying, I'm going to explain you what is check function. I have made it above the main function basically. So low is equals to mid. If mid is satisfying, it means I am going to check it into the right part. So low is equals to mid. If mid is not satisfying, it means I am going to check into the left part. In the end, I am going to check low and high, and whichever satisfy will be the answer. So now let us talk about the check function. Okay, this is the check function. So before you can also make the check function on your own. What is the check function? Basically, we have to check that all the matrix of mid cross mid should satisfy the property. If any of them don't satisfy the property, it means I am going to return false. Fine. So what is DP? I have taken matrix as global and DP as that sum. So what it means is, what is DP? See, this suppose this is the normal matrix 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 1 2 3 4. This is the 4 cross 4 matrix. Okay. So what is DP? So DP of I comma j defines as, just have a look, DP of I comma j is equals to sum of all elements from 0 comma 0 to I comma j, sorry, 1 comma 1 to 1 comma 1 to i comma j. What does it mean? Okay, so this is what DP of I comma j contains. Okay, suppose I have to calculate DP of this is instance indexing is 1, so this value is 2 comma 2. So DP of 2 comma 2 means I am going to sum all the elements from index 1 comma 1 to 2 comma 2. So it is going to contain these four numbers 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6. Okay, suppose I want DP of 3 comma 3, so it means DP of 3 comma 3 will contains all the sum of all the elements include having 1 plus 2 plus 3 5 plus 6 plus 7 9 plus 10 plus 11. Correct. So you are going to calculate the sub array from 1 comma 1 to I comma j. Correct. If I want to calculate for this, so I am going to have this, these three numbers, like these six numbers, 1 2 3 5 6 7. I hope it's quite clear. Okay, suppose I have to calculate this, so it will contain some of these numbers, because 1 comma 1 to 1 comma 3. Correct. This is 1 comma 4, this is 1 comma 2. Suppose I want to calculate for this number, it means I'm going to have sum of all those numbers. These will be included, 1 plus 5 plus 9. So how we are going to calculate it? So why are we calculating it? Because I have to minimize the check function basically. Okay. So what I have to do is, what I can do is, for the first row, I can sum all the elements as the prefix sum. So first element will be the element itself 1. सेकेंड एलिमेंट विल बी इक्वल टू द दिस प्लस करंट एलिमेंट. सो 1 + 2 = 3 एंड दिस एलिमेंट सपोज फॉर दिस आई एम गोइंग टू गेट द वैल्यू एट वैल्यू ऑफ डी पी एट दिस प्लस 3. सो वैल्यू एट दिस इज 3. बेसिकली आई एम गोइंग टू प्रीफिक्स सम. ओके जस्ट हैव द प्रीफिक्स सम हेयर. फॉर द फर्स्ट कॉलम यू कैन हैव द प्रीफिक्स सम हेयर. ओके 1 + 5 = 6, 6 + 9 = 15 एंड 15 + 1 = 16. ओके फॉर द फर्स्ट रो एंड फर्स्ट कॉलम यू आर गोइंग टू टेक द प्रीफिक्स सम. नाउ हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट फॉर अ नॉर्मल आई कॉमेडी अदर देन द फर्स्ट रो एंड कॉलम. सो बेसिकली वी आर गोइंग टू चेक इज फॉर दिस वैल्यू वॉट आर यू गोइंग टू चेक इज सी सी सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट फॉर दिस. सो वॉट इट मीन्स सपोज सी आई एम हैविंग अ वैल्यू दिस. आई हैव ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू अबव दिस एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू अबव दिस. सो वॉट आई कैन डू इज आई कैन जस्ट एड दीज टू नंबर्स. But what happens is when you are just adding these numbers, so it means this subarray is coming twice. This subarray is coming twice. Okay, what I mean. Okay, suppose I want to calculate for this. So what I can do is 6 + 3 = 9, and I'm going to sum this current element. So 9 + 6 = 15, right? When but it is 14. You can see always 1 + 2 + 5 + 6 = 14. Okay. 6 + 5 = 11, 11 + 3 = 14. So when are you see what does this DP mean? This DP means that I'm going to have sum till here. What does this DP mean till this position? This means 1 + 5. So when you are adding these two numbers, it means the sum matrix above this is calculated twice. So I have to reduce this once. Okay, so 6 + 3 - 1 + current element. Now calculate for this. Okay, what I am saying is, see, you can always have a look here. See, so I am going to add the top value of DP, which is 6 here. I am going to the right left part, say 14, which is 14 here. And see, what does DP of this means? This means sum of all the elements here. And sum of all the elements here is 6 + 2 + 1 + 5. Okay, what does DP of this means? This means 1 + 2 + 3. So when you are adding these two numbers, you can always see that you are adding these this subarray twice. So what I can do is I can reduce this. So what I'm going to do, 14 plus 6 plus current element minus this. 14 plus 6 is 20. 20 minus 3 is 17. And 17 plus 7 is 24. You can always check 1 plus 2 plus 3, 5 plus 6 plus 7. Correct? I hope it is quite clear. Suppose I want to calculate for 11. So whenever you are calculating this value, what you can do is 13 plus 24 minus this. Why are you doing minus this? See, what does DP of this position contains? 1 plus 2 plus 3, 5 plus 6 plus 7. What does this DP contains? 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6 plus 9 plus 10. So whenever you are adding these two numbers, so you can always see that 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6 is added twice in this. We have to calculate these numbers, right? So you are already having this number, then you can going to add this and you are going to subtract this value. This value is 14 here. I hope it's quite clear. Okay, so now you can have a look of how I have created the DP. So initially I have created a DP and I have initialized it with 0. So DP of 1, 1 is equal to first element, and this is the prefix sum of the first row. This is the prefix sum of the first column. Correct, you can always see DP of 1, I is equals to DP of 1, i - 1 + this is the prefix sum basically. You can always check. Okay, now for I, j, how I am going to calculate DP of I, j is equals to DP of i - 1, j. What is DP of i - 1, j? You are standing I, j. This is suppose I am standing on I, j. So the i - 1, j is this value, upper part, and this is i, j - 1. So basically what I'm going to do is DP of I'm going to add these two values and I'm going to subtract i - 1 - j - 1. Why I'm subtracting? For suppose I'm going to calculate for this, so I have to subtract this. This is i, j, this is i - 1 - j - 1. Okay, so I'm going to subtract this and add the current element. You might have understood how I have calculated the DP. Okay, so why I'm using this, so why I'm calculating this. Okay, suppose you are standing on I, j and you want a sum matrix of 2. You are going to check. So suppose you are standing 6. So this is the first leftmost index I, j. you have to find the 2 cross 2 matrix. So from I comma j, what you can do is I plus 2 minus 1. Suppose this, what is this index? This is 2 comma 2. From 2 comma 2, you have to find the 2 cross 2 matrix. So you can always go 2 plus 2. See? Okay, I can tell you here. You are standing on 2 comma 2. Okay? Then you want, this is the first part. So the rightmost index of 2 comma 2 this is a 2 comma 2. I want a 2 cross 2 matrix. So what is the rightmost part? Rightmost down index. This will be equals to 2 plus 2. I want a 2 plus 2 minus 1 comma 2 plus 2 minus 1 equals to 3 comma 3. Okay. You can always check it here. This is 6 comma 7, 2 comma 2. So what is 2 plus 2 from here? 6 plus 7 plus 10 plus 11. Right. So this is what the rightmost part. So how you are going to check in open? See, you are on 6 comma 7. So what you can do is you can add this part. So what you can do is, suppose you are standing on 2 comma 3. So answer will be equals to answer means the sum of all the elements with 2 comma 2 as the leftmost index of a submatrix of size 2. So I am going to add dp of 3 comma 3. Dp of 3 comma 3. What does dp of 3 comma 3 contain? Sum of all the elements from 1 comma 1 to 3 comma 3. But I don't want this now. What I want is 6 plus 7 and 10 plus 11. So you can always see ke jo 11 agar 11 ke corresponding 54 hai. 54 ka kya matlab hai? 1 plus 2 plus 3, 5 plus 6 plus 7, 9 plus 10 plus 11. Iske andar faltu kya hai? Faltu ye wala part hai. Ek to upar wala part hai jo 6 comma 7 se just upar hai aur ye wala part hai. Theek hai? To hum kya karenge? Ye dono part minus kar denge. Ye dono part iska index kya hoga? Ye I comma j hai. ये i प्लस मिड माइनस वन है. ओके, जैसे हमने ये किया है i प्लस मिड माइनस वन, i प्लस मिड माइनस वन, j प्लस मिड माइनस वन, बेसिकली ये है. ठीक है, मिड मतलब साइज. तो हमें अगर मैं इसका इंडेक्स पालूंगा तो आई एम गोइंग टू सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस फ्रॉम dp ऑफ ये एंड आई एम गोइंग टू सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस. सो व्हेन यू आर डूइंग दिस यू कैन ऑलवेज सी दैट यू आर सब्ट्रैक्टिंग दिस पार्ट ट्वाइस. सो आई एम गोइंग टू एड इट वंस. सो दिस इज द सेम लॉजिक विच वी यूज हियर. Instead of adding, now we are subtracting. Instead of subtracting, we are adding. Okay. Now let me give an example. Okay. Suppose this is the first index. This is 3 comma 3. From 3 comma 3, I want some matrix of suppose say 2. So what I can do is from 3 comma 3 is the rightmost index is 3 plus mid minus 1 and 3 plus mid minus 1. So okay. So this is the rightmost. So 3 plus mid minus 1, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 minus 1, 4. So 4 comma 4. So 4 comma 4 contains 88, dp of 88. So this 88 contains extra sum of element which is having this, correct? And which is having these 6 element, 1 plus 3, 6 plus 4. So if I can reduce this value, if I am going to subtract this value, it means I will be reducing the element with the sum 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8. If I am going to subtract this value, it means I am going to subtract 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6, 9 plus 10 and 1 plus 2. So, iske andar extra kya kya tha? 11, 12, 3, 4. So, iske andar extra kya hai? Ye wala part. Upar ke 6 aur ye side ke 6. 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6. Agar main ye reduce kar diya, to ye cut gaya. Ye reduce kar diya, to ye wala cut gaya. Okay? But, iske andar ye wala part jo hai, 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6, 2 bar cut gaya hai. तो उसको इस वाले पार्ट को एक बार ऐड करना पड़ेगा. ये वाला पार्ट कौन सा है? आई माइनस वन कॉमा जे वन माइनस वन. ठीक है. सो नाउ लुक एट द चेक फंक्शन. वी हैव अ बूल फ्लैग ट्रू. इफ एनी ऑफ द सब मैट्रिक्स ऑफ मिड क्रॉस मिड इज नॉट सेटिस्फाइंग, आई एम गोइंग टू डू फ्लैग एज फॉल्स. ओके, सो आई एम गोइंग टू चेक आई इज इक्वल टू वन, आई लेस देन इक्वल टू एन माइनस मिड प्लस वन, आई प्लस प्लस, जे इज इक्वल टू वन, जे लेस देन इक्वल टू एन माइनस मिड प्लस वन. सो इफ डीपी ऑफ आई, ये डीपी कौन सी है? ये वाली जो राइट इंडेक्स देती है, राइट मोस्ट लेफ्ट पार्ट. ओके, दिस वन. इसमें से कौन सा सब माइनस वन करना पड़ेगा? ये वाला पार्ट. देखो अभी हम यहाँ पे थे, ठीक है, हमें ये वाला पार्ट रिड्यूस करना पड़ेगा. इस पार्ट की वैल्यू क्या है? एक इंडेक्स ऊपर तो आई माइनस वन आ गया, और ये जेथ वाला तो जे प्लस मिड माइनस वन, एक पार्ट ऊपर वाला माइनस कर दिया, दैट इज ये वाला, और हमें ये वाला माइनस करना पड़ेगा. ये वाला कौन सा पार्ट है? ये आई कॉमा जे है, तो ये जे माइनस वन हो गया, जे माइनस वन हो गया. इस आई की वैल्यू क्या है? आई प्लस मिड माइनस वन. ओके, ये दो माइनस कर दिए, क्योंकि पर ये वाला जो पार्ट है वो दो बार माइनस हो गया, 1+3 ये वाला पार्ट, 1+2+5+7, सो आई एम गोइंग टू ऐड दिस वंस, ओके. सो दिस इज हाउ आई कैन गेट द एनी सम मैट्रिक्स ऑफ साइज मिड क्रॉस मिड इन ओ ऑफ वन. सो बेसिकली ओके, इफ दिस इज ग्रेटर देन मैक्सिमम सम इट मीन्स द मैट्रिक्स ऑफ एक्स मिड क्रॉस मिड, सम मैट्रिक्स मिड क्रॉस मिड इज हैविंग द सम ग्रेटर देन मैक्सिमम. So I'm going to return, I'm going to put flag as false and I'm going to return it. So just try to understand this part, okay? Why we are calculating DP? If we are not calculating DP, then what will be the time complexity? So I can tell you the time complexity of this algorithm. The time complexity of this algorithm is this part takes log n times, okay? And this part takes O of nm. So basically you are calculating the answer in O of n square into log n. Into log n, okay, and it will satisfy because n is less than or equal to 10^3. I hope the question is quite clear to you. So this question was asked in 2018 also and 2019 also, okay. So this is one of the important question and it's quite good because you will be able to understand this how to calculate the prefix sum and how this is important, okay. This you can always check how to calculate the sum of all elements of size square of square matrix. So you can always check, this is the basically the proper method because this helps in giving in O of 1. So basically for every I comma j of size mid, we are going to calculate in O of 1. This is O of 1 basically, okay. So thanks for watching, do like and subscribe. Thanks.